1절에서 5절 말씀.
Verses 1 through 5.
1148면이 되겠습니다.
It is in the page of 1148. We'll have responsive reading. The precious sons of Zion worth their weight in fine gold, how they are regarded as earthen pots, the works of the potter's hands.
그들의 새끼를 먹이나 딸의 백성은 잔인하여 마치 강야의 타조 같도다.
The tongues of the nursing infant sticks to the roof of its mouth for thirst. The children beg for food, but no one gives to them. Let us read together. Those who once feasted on delicacies perish in the streets. Those who were brought up in purple embrace ash heaps. Amen. Today is the Hana Remnant Conference. Let us greet each other in a new way. And God says He loves you. Look to the person next to you and say it. God says He loves you. And God says He will love you.
하나님이 너를 어둠에 그만두지 않으신데.
And He will not leave you in the darkness.
믿습니까?
Do you believe?
너무 은혜로운 찬양 너무 감사하고요.
Thank you for the graceful praise.
오늘 예배하는 가운데서 정말로 하나님이 나를 사랑하시는 그 축복이 확인되어지는 그런 축복의 시간들 되기를 바랍니다.
I really hope that this time may be the blessed time where you really know the blessings of receiving the love of God. And today's title is The Urgent Remnant Movement. If there is a ministry that we must do to the end, what is it? It is raising up the spiritual prosperities, that is the eternal ministry. If your lives are not connected with raising up the spiritual prosperities, then you can say that your lives are not connected and are not inside of God. You guys must all possess a schedule for the remnants. What is spoken most importantly inside of the Bible is the covenant. And whenever the covenant is relayed, there is something that we always see. And that is the promise, the covenant regarding the prosperities. Then to match with God's plan, then we must all have a schedule for our prosperities. Inside of the world, there are people who succeed and do not. It is, are they able to, capable of raising up the workers or not? And if you see the companies, the enterprises that are well off, what they always say is, let's raise up the gifted individuals. And I saw this one article on how to raise up the gifted individuals. Harvard donated the funds about $27 trillion so that they can raise up the gifted individuals. And if you see the Jewish people, they have the coming of age ceremony. And during the coming of age, age ceremony, they will attach specialists to those children. And they will also attach the specialist to the parents so that they can raise up their children. And America is a superpower nation. So about 150 to 200 nations are gathered inside of America. And what do they see most important? What they most focus on is raising up the gifted individual regardless of their ethnicity. In Europe, they don't receive a college tuition. Whatever the ethnicity they may be, they can all come if they're the gifted individuals, they can study there. And those are the superpower nations. Even these worldly people, they are in the forefront doing this ministry. Then, as the children of God, what must we hold on to and what must we pray for? We must all full-fledged go together to raise up the prosperities. Why is it? It is because the prosperities are the people who are inside of the interest of God, and they are the people who will lead the future churches. That is why you must all have the heart for our prosperities. Then to truly have the prayer and the hearts for the prosperities, we must first see how the world is being led right now. Right now, it's already late. But if you truly hold on to the covenant at this time, then it's not late, and God will truly give us His answers and lead us. Yesterday, we had the top remnant take place at our church. And as I attended, as I was seeing the performances of our remnants, I truly had a heart for the remnants. And I was able to see that God is truly raising up our remnants. And we were able to see how the thoughts of our remnants are different from ours. They must not be on the same level as us. And I was able to see how God is truly training them in different ways. And during the afternoon, when we have all the people gathered together, we'll have the people who received the award come up and present again. As I attended the performances, I saw this one kid, and he showed a video of how he exercises because he was not able to perform doing the exercise for himself, he placed it in the, he recorded it and he presented it. And as I saw that video, I thought to myself, oh, this is what it is. And after that, I told the parents how I felt. They were able to find exercise that fits that child. You guys might not know, but I knew this remnant while he was still young, and I was able to see the parents caught on and is training him inside of the exercise that fits most to him. And I was able to realize, oh, we do not know what kind of individual or gifted individual that will come out. And that is why we must full-fledged place all of our hearts to raise up our prosperities. Why is that?
잘못된 문화와 잘못된 이념 사상으로 말미암아 우리 아이들이 어느 것이 옳고 그른지도 모르고 끌려가게 되는 것입니다.
That is because right now the, our prosperities are being led in the wrong ideology. And they were born, but they're living inside of the incorrect culture.
그 문화 속에서 태어나고
they're born in the culture of Genesis 3, 6, and 11, and they're being raised up inside of
that.
And this wrong ideology and the thoughts are keep on coming inside of them through the educations.
And their
hearts are stolen away because of this incorrect ideology.
전 세계는 이념 전쟁이에요, 사실.
In the world, it is the war regarding ideology and the culture.
아니야, 이 이념 전쟁이 전 세계에서 일어나고 있어.
Is it the right wing or the left wing? It is this ideology. And because of that, we are able to see many wars arise.
어떤 사상을 가진 사람이 정치를 잡고 있냐에 따라서도 많은 부분의 국민들이 거기에 따라가게 돼.
So the leader of the one nation, what kind of ideology they may have, the people, the citizens, follow after that. And our prosperities, while they're still young, they're falling into this incorrect ideology. And they have no choice but to sway left and right. It is because they're being they're falling into this lies is fair.
강대국도 민족주의를 이야기를 해요.
Even the superpower nations talk about nationalism. Nationalism is not a bad thing.
근데 전 세계가 지금 객관성 없는 민족주의 때문에
각 나라 But they have lost hold of the objectivity. That is why this nationalism is a very fearsome thing and many wars arise because of this. And whatever other people say, it is the global age right now.
237 나라 세계 복음화에 기한 언약을 이스라엘 백성에게 주셨는데 그 사실을 깨닫지 못하니까 후대들은 노예되고 포로되고
God has given the Israelites this precious covenant, but because they were not able to realize, you can see the prosperities falling into enslavement, captivity, and colonization. Right now, it's the same for our age.
하나님께서 우리나라 경제를 축복하셔서 전 세계 다민족들이 지금 우리나라 현장에 들어오게 돼 있어요.
Many of the multi-ethnics are coming to our coming inside of Korea. And now they're giving the visas to the multi-ethnics so that they can come and study here.
여름 속에 우리 아이들이 어떠한 인물로 아이 준비되어야 되느냐? 우리가 정말 눈을 뜨고 정신 차려야 되는 거예요.
So we must really come to our senses and open up our eyes to see how we must raise up our prosperities in this kind of age. And there are these wrong organizations that are arising right now. And center around America and Europe, it is the Freemasons, the three organizations our remnants all know. What is the three organization? It is the New Age movement. It is the Freemason movement and the Jewish people. So what are these three organizations doing? They are doing the Nephilim movement. They're doing the possession movement. And they're raising up great gifted individuals from those three organizations. That is why they have great influence. So through the Nephilim movement, they show great power. So the people of the Nephilim, what they came out with, it is the transcendental meditation or secular meditation. And many people are deceived by this. And especially the elites are fallen into this. But what is the result of the secular meditation movement? It creates great problems of spiritual problems that people do not know. And many organizations, evil criminals arise in drugs and gambling. And they're utilizing the prosperities right now. And you saw last week.
And
the students of Seoul University, Yonsei University, and those universities, they gathered together and they had a party of drugs. And now they brought in the university students of other universities and they're selling drugs to them. And these kind of works are rising right now. What would you think if your children is at that field? But those kind of works are arising, those kind of incidents are arising inside of our fields.
열심히 노력하다 보니까 어느 날 성공하는 자리에 이르는 것 같습니다.
Because they place their efforts, it might seem as if they're in a position of success.
공허함을 달래기 위해서 이런저런 중독에 빠지기도 하고.
But they, after they have success, they have this void inside of them, and they're trying to fill that up. But our remnants, our prosperities, are inside of that field, and it is the path that our prosperities have no choice but to face. So through the word, we must truly hold on to how we must prepare our prosperities. We just have to realize and we are able to receive answers. If you just realize what the churches must do, then God will answer us.
창세기 4장 1절에서 20절에 나온 것처럼 여러분 가인처럼 종교를 가르치면은 안 되는 것입니다.
Just again, Genesis 4, 1 through 20, we must not teach religious things to.
교회는 복음만 가르쳐야 됩니다.
Inside of the church, like Cain, we must only teach the gospel.
모든 것은 다 따라오게 돼 있다는 사실.
And when we relay and teach the gospel, only Christ, everything else will follow.
그 자체가 타락인 것이죠.
If we keep on blocking the gospel with the things that is not the gospel, then that itself is corruption. And just as it says in Genesis 37, 1 through 11, the brothers of Joseph, they only knew the physical things. We must be able to see, isn't that how we think as well?
창세기 37장 4절에 보면은 그들의 마음에 시기함이 일어났다 했습니다.
So if you see, because Joseph was loved by his father, it is in Genesis 37:4 says, "But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peacefully to him."
요셉의 형들은 전부 육신적인 것에만 관심이 있었습니다.
Unlike Joseph, the brothers, they only thought about the physical things. And so unknowingly, the Israelites had no choice but to fall into enslavement. And you are able to see when the Israelites were enslaved, God prepared Moses to make them come out. So we must truly know the great blessings of the covenant that we possess. We might not possess the physical things, but because we are relating the spiritual things, you must know how important this is. If you do that, then our prosperities will be enslaved. Without the fault of their own, they will be enslaved. We must only speak of the gospel. The churches must not talk about religious things. Inside of the church, yes, the physical things are important, but that must not be emphasized. We must only emphasize the spiritual things. It is talking about how important this thing is that we must relate to our prosperities. Inside of our passage, it tells us the thing that cannot happen arose. How can gold lose its light? But that kind of result came. And what does it say? It says the tongues of the nursing infant sticks to the roof. The children begs for food, but no one gives to them. So the children are asking for food, but no one is giving it to them. And they were so in thirst, their tongues stick to the top of the roof of its mouth. We might think that we are doing good, but what happens if the tongues of our children stick to the roof of its mouth? So we must truly open up our spiritual eyes and go all in inside of this ministry. And if you see in Acts 1:6, the disciples asked Jesus, "Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel?" So they were colonized at that time. They lost hold of the gospel. And when we do not speak and relay the gospel, then our prosperities have no choice but to be enslaved, colonized, and held captives. So what are the churches right now? How are the churches at this time Right now, the churches are diminishing. So we were able to see the records. So we have these organizations inside of Christianity. And they give this results, this reports, and they give up this reports. But it hasn't been that long, but about 120 churches have disappeared. So about 3,000 churches disappeared inside of Korea. And right now, inside of America, over 10,000 churches have diminished. And many of the churches are turning into restaurants and stores. And I was able to hear that report. So, if you see the statistics, in the year of 2030, 100,000 churches will close their doors inside of America.
2030년에 미국의 10만 교회가 문을 닫게 될 것이다 이야기했어요.
So as the statistics tell us, 100,000 churches inside of America alone will close their doors, and many of the people are leaving the church. Now people are not interested in religion anymore. So how is it like in Korea? We're talking about the age of the three-day weekend.
하나 되어서 검토 시대를 통해서 우리 후대에 대한 집중할 수 있는 시간이 되어지라.
Our church officers must truly have a time to concentrate for the age of the three-day weekend.
금요일 예배가 없는 교회가 많아요.
Even in the churches of Korea alone, there are many churches that do not have Wednesday night service and Friday night service.
나름대로 교회에 대한 기도회들이 있습니다.
We have on Wednesdays and Fridays, we gather together and give worship. But there are so many churches that are not doing this right now. And even the Sunday schools, 70% of the churches in Korea are not, they do not have a meeting of the Sunday schools. And they had this inspection on, they inspected on how much of pre-infant and kindergarten students are inside of churches. Right now, they do not have those kind of children, and they also do not have the ministers for that. And all of the churches are falling into this. And as time goes on, it will get worse. And how are the churches right now? And now, the churches are viewed negatively to the world right now. And the world turned their backs on the churches. But why did this results arise? Is it because they do not have some kind of program? No. It is because they neglect the gospel. Gospel is the only thing that can solve this problem, but they neglected it.
큰 일을 하지 않는다 할지라도 여러분 때문에 모든 현장과 모든 후대는 살아나게 될 것입니다.
So for all of you who possess the gospel, you might not do great things, but through you, prosperities and the world will be changed.
내 자녀, 네 자녀 할 필요가 없는 것입니다.
So we do not have to talk about your child or my child.
되어서 렘넌트를 키워야 되는 것입니다.
All of the churches must come together to raise up the remnants.
영원한 사역인 후대를 제자로 세우는 이 사역이 아니고서는
If it is not for the ministry of raising up our prosperities inside of the future, then there's no hope for the future. So our prosperities are the futures for the churches and all of your future. In the Wednesday night service, we had this passage come out. It is Isaiah 59:21. Let us all read together. And as for me, this is my covenant with them, says the Lord, my spirit that is upon you and my words that I have put in your mouth shall not depart out of your mouth or out of the mouth of your offsprings or out of the mouth of your children's offerings, says the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. So I have put in your mouth, and that shall not depart from you and your offsprings and the offspring's offspring. God has called us all together to Hana Church for this work. And then secondly, if you just hold on to the covenant right now, we start anew right now. So we must start anew. And the same for us and same for the remnants. We must start anew so that the gospel may root down inside of our prosperities and us.
우리 후대들이 또 우리 자신들이 영적 문제에 당하지 않도록 복음의 뿌리를 내려야 하는 것입니다.
We must root down inside the gospel, same for us and the prosperities, so that they do not fall inside of the spiritual problems. We just have to hold on to it correctly and enjoy. And these four points must be rooted down inside of us. What is the first? It's Matthew 16:16. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. This must be rooted down inside of us that Jesus is the Christ. I told you in the early morning prayer service. This Peter, he confessed this. But what kind of blessings did Jesus give to Peter? He gave the blessing so that he can save himself and the prosperities. And he says, you are the rock, and upon that rock I will raise up the church. I will save the church. That's what it says. When we know Christ, we are able to save myself and the church. And the gates of Hades shall not overcome it. There absolutely is the authorities of Satan, hell, and sin. But in the end, we will have victory. Do you guys have depression? Do you guys have panic disorders? Or are you guys in the midst of failure? Those who absolutely hold on to the covenant of Christ, they will have victory. The gates of Hades will never overcome it. And he will give us the keys to heaven. When we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, the answers of the throne will be given to us. The answers, the blessings, the grace that is given to us, it is all given from the throne. That is why we must root down inside of Christ every day. And secondly, and as the evidence that he is Christ, he resurrected. If you see Matthew 28:16-20, you are able to see the resurrected Christ. If he did not resurrect, then Christ cannot be Christ. As the evidence that he has solved the problems of death, he resurrected. And this must be rooted down inside of us. He resurrected, but where is he right now? He's working through us. He's working upon us through the Holy Spirit. We might not be able to see it, but through the Holy Spirit, Christ is still at work. And in Acts 2:1-47, so it is the Christ who realistically saves the churches and the world. And when these four points root down inside of us, that is when we are able to truly have victory spiritually. And this must root down also inside of our prosperities. It's Christ who has solved all of our problems, and as evidence that He is Christ, He has resurrected, and He's still at work through the Holy Spirit. And it's the Christ that saves the churches and the world. And we must relay this to our prosperity so that it may be imprinted and rooted down inside of them. Then we are able to have specialty arise inside of us. So in the future, we must help our prosperity so that they may hold on to the specialty inside of this. Inside of the age of the three-day weekend, we must have victory and success. You're able to see that in the Western nations, America and Europe, because of the age of the three-day weekend, they are leaving the church because they're going on vacation. They're leaving the church and they're not gathering inside of the church. And right now, inside of Korea as well, when we're having the holidays, let's have 5 day, Saturday and Sunday, and let's gather all of the holidays on those days. And that is what Korea is saying right now. And the system is inside of Korea are also changing in that manner. Then what will happen to the prosperities? Yes, the worldly educations, yes, it might take place, but what will happen to the spiritual education? So that is why we must have an internship that take place during the age of the three-day weekend. So that they may hold on to this gospel that saves themselves, and so that they can be raised up as the remnants, holding on to the gospel to save the world and save the age. You must truly pray for this. The more this gospel is rooted down inside of us, we are able to save myself, we are able to overcome the world, and we are able to save the age. That power is given inside of the gospel. Gospel itself, it is power and authority. That is why Paul says, I am not embarrassed of the gospel, because the gospel saves everything. Gospel itself is strength to us, and gospel itself is power to us. What kind of power? What kind of strength? It is the strength to save myself, and that is inside of the gospel. And the power to the strength to change the world is inside of the gospel. And the strength to save the age is inside of the gospel. If this mystery of 24 is related to our prosperities, they're able to save themselves and the world. How can we save the world? How can we overcome the world? We cannot do it with our strength. That is why when we are able to really enjoy 24-hour prayer and go inside of 25 prayer, we are able to save the world. And God will give us the blessing of eternity. And when we hold on to this and pray, God will give us the power, the strength to save the world. That was the message that was given to us during the World Renewal Conference and the Leaders Retreat. And this is the prayer that you guys must all hold on to. Prayer, 24 prayer, 25 prayer, and prayer of eternity. And this is the strength to save myself and to change the age.
여러분의 기도가 있기를 주 이름으로
축원합니다. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May your prayers be inside of this so that you may save the prosperities.
말씀을 맺겠습니다.
I'll come to the end of my words.
여러분 힘이 없다고 생각하십니까?
Do you think that you have no strength?
그리스도 믿는 순간에 이미 주어졌어요.
The moment you believe in Christ, this strength is given to you already.
기도하면 돼.
You just have to pray a little bit.
여러분 하나님의 소원은 사람을 살리는 것입니다.
God's wish or His hopes, His will is to save the people. And what God sees most important, it is to save the prosperities. How can we save people? How can we save myself, the people, and our prosperities? We cannot do it with our own strength. That is why God has given us the gospel. When we just hold on to the gospel and go inside of prayer, we are able to save myself, and we are able to save the prosperities, the future, and we are able to go inside of that blessings. I bless you in the name of the Lord that may these blessings be a blessing that our Hana Church truly holds on to anew.
Remnant 운동을 마음에 담은 전도 제자의 기도입니다. 같이 한번 읽어보십시다. 영원한 사역인 영적 후대를 세우는 일에 올인하게 하옵소서. 복음의 부재 시대에 오직 복음으로 시대 살리는 증인되게 하옵소서. 기도로 나 세상 시대를 살리는 힘을 가지고 나아가게 하소서. 기도 제목들 마음에 담으면서 함께 찬양하겠습니다. 주여 나의 삶 속에
나의 삶 속에 임마누엘 누리게 하소서. 나의 생각 나의 자금이 하나님 것이 내게 하소서. 성도 하나님 소원은 그를 넘어서 하나님께 축복을 넘어서 하나님 없다고 인간 사랑을 넘어서 하나님 사랑
잡고 한번 기도하십시다. 시급한 렘넌트 운동이지만은 하나님께서 우리에게 언약 주심으로 말미암아 새로운 시작을 하게 하셨습니다. 정말 이 한 시대에 하나님의 소원인 또 우리 교회의 미래인 우리 후대들을 우리의 마음에 담는 귀한 축복의 시간들 되게 하시고 이들이 일어나서 나를 살리는 힘을 가지고 나가며 세상을 바꾸는 힘을 가지고 나가며 시대를 살리는 힘을 가지고 나감으로 말미암아 이 땅에 하나님의 나라가 이들 통해서 이루어짐을 볼 수 있도록 우리 교회에 그 증거를 주옵시고 우리가 거기에 신부름하는 발판이 되게 역사하여 주옵소서. 우리 모든 렘넌트들은 한 시대의 복음 운동 속에 주역으로 쓰임받을 수 있도록 주님 역사하여 주옵소서. 우리 같이 한 음성으로 한번 기도하겠습니다. 전능하신 하나님 아버지 우리에게 귀중한 은혜를 붙잡을 수 있도록 축복하여 주시고 새로운 신작을 할 수 있도록 인도하여 주심을 감사함을 드립니다. 우리 모든 성도들이 우리 렘넌트들이 함께 복음의 뿌리를 내림으로 복음 뿌리 내림 속에서 주어지는 기도의 힘을 가지고 적응성을 찾아내고 복음의 뿌리 내림 불길을 가지고 함께 나를 살리며 또 세상을 바꾸며 시대를 살리려 주옥들로 주입받는 양자락의 모든 성도들 될 수 있도록